what he's done for you. Are y'all with me here? Seeking the Lord says, I trust you. Seeking the Lord is sincere gratitude. And the spirit of sincere gratitude and thankfulness ought to be a shining virtue that is easily recognizable within the life of every Christian believer. True gratitude is thankfulness. True gratitude and thankfulness is more than the expression of mere words. It is to be the disposition of one's heart. It is more than a polite and civil gesture. It is to be an ever-present attitude. And it is more than just a moment and a monetary action. It is to be a continual lifestyle. You should never be to the point to where you are not grateful. You should never get to the point to where you are not thanking God. Because each day of our life, God is in some shape, form, or fashion doing things for us. Have I got a witness here? If you have a home to live in, you ought to be thankful. If you have a source of income, you ought to be thankful. If you have a bed to sleep on, you ought to be thankful. Yeah. If you have sufficient food to eat, you ought to be thankful. And I know we're on the backside of Christmas. Have I got a witness here? And on yesterday, all of us sat around the table enjoying food to eat. Have I got a witness here? And while we are enjoying food to eat, it was a celebration of our Christ being born. Have I got a witness here? And if you have food to eat, yes, Lord, you ought to be thankful. Have I got a witness? If you have decent clothes to wear, you ought to be thankful. If you are able to sleep at night, you ought to be thankful. Have I got a witness here? And if God has forgiven you of all of your sins, you ought to be grateful. If God has delivered you from danger seen and unseen, you ought to be thankful. Have I got a witness? And if the Lord has ever healed your body, you ought to be thankful. Have I got a witness? And if the Lord, yes, God, has ever answered your prayers, you ought to be thankful. Yes, Lord. And if the Lord has ever provided for you, you ought to be thankful. And if God has ever blessed your life in any kind of way, you ought to be thankful. Have I got a witness here? Because the Bible says, be thankful unto him and then bless his name. Why? Because the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endure it to all generations. And I just want to know, on this last Sunday of 21, is there anybody in here you are thankful for what the Lord Lord has done for you. And I don't know how you feel about it. I wouldn't be where I am had it not been for the Lord. Have I got a witness here? And truth of the matter, you wouldn't be where you are had it not been for the Lord who was on your side. And if you are thankful for what the Lord has done for you, then you ought to give him praise. You ought to be telling the Lord, Lord, I thank you for what you've done in my life. The Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If the Lord woke you up this morning, you ought to say so. If the Lord gave you the activities of your limb, you ought to say so. And if the Lord has been good to you, you ought to say so. Is there anybody here feel like praising his name? Is there anybody in here, when you look back over your life, you can say without a doubt, I have so much to thank God for. Oh, I'm out of here now, but can I bother you just one time? Can you turn and look at your neighbor, look at your neighbor in the eye, and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I don't know what you've been going through, but one thing I know, everything is gonna be all right. Is there anybody here? Do you believe it? Everything. 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 Everything is gonna be all right. That's why I can thank God in advance. That's why I can put my hands up and tell God thank you, because I know he will make a way somehow. He will provide for you. He will heal your body. He will wipe tears from your eyes. Well, can I ask you one question? Ain't he all right? Do you know he's all right? Say yeah. Say